Hello everybody and welcome to another episode. In today's episode I am going to show you how to replace the front shock absorber along with the sway bar links on any BMW 3 Series E46. So as you can see, I already lifted both of the front wheels up. So to begin the job, what you have to do is to open the hood, and after that you'll have to undo, you'll have to remove those three bolts from right here from the top, but don't remove them completely. You will only want to remove them just a little bit to make them loose, and after that you'll have to go right here and you'll have to remove the sway bunning. But in my case, as you can see right here, the sway bunning is mounted right here on the shock absorber, but the sway bar is not right here because the sway bar is broken and the owner threw it away. So I only have to remove the metal part, I only have to remove the screws which are holding the sway bar link, the ball joint from the sway bar link. And after that you'll have to remove the bolt which is securing the shock absorber mounted to the hub, and then you'll have to remove the bolt which is holding the lower control arm mounted to the hub. But in some cases, if the lower control arm is not coming out very easy, you can just let it like this, because you don't want to break it completely and create even more problems to your car. So to begin, you'll have to use a 70mm key to hold the ball joint from not moving around when you try to remove the nut from the sway bar link. And as you can see, this is the position for me in my case, and with the other one I'm using my impact gun to remove the bolt which is securing the sway bar link mounted to the car. So right here, I hope you all have a better look, and as you can see, with one hand I'm using the impact gun and with the other hand I'm using the ball joint, the sway bar, from not moving around when I try to remove the nut. And it came out very easy. Okay everybody, now with the sway bar removed from the top and also from the bottom, those are the ball joints from the sway bar link in my case, because the sway bar is broken. What we have to do next is to remove this nut from right here, which is securing the control arm from the lower side mounted to the hub. And to remove it, you'll have to use some extensions, and you will also have to use a special tool which will help you to put the socket over the bolt in any tight spot. So after you remove the bolt from the lower arm, you'll have to remove the bolt which is securing the shock absorber mounted to the hub. To remove it, you'll have to use an 80mm socket, and I also recommend all to use some WD-40 and spray it over the bolts, because in this way it will help you to remove them a little bit easier. And also I recommend all to disconnect the cables from the ABS sensors, because you don't want to stretch the hub, and also you don't want to stretch the cables, because in some cases you can break them and you'll have more problems in the future. And as you can see, I tried to remove the lower control arm from this car, but it's not coming out, and I don't want to put stress on the bolt, I don't want to put stress on the ball joint, and because of that I will have to remove the shock absorber using a little bit of force. So you'll have to remove the bolt from the top, and to remove it from the hub you'll have to turn it a little bit more to the exterior, and eventually it will come out from its place. I also recommend all to remove the caliper along with the caliper mounting bracket, because in this way, if you don't remove it, you'll put a lot of pressure and force to the cables, and in some cases you can break the cables like I told you earlier. So just remove the caliper. I don't recommend all to let it hang on the brake line, but for just a short period of time it's not a very bad idea. So as you can see, in my case right here, the camera stopped focusing, but I was able to remove it in this position. I had to push a little bit harder from the lower control arm, and the shock absorber came out from its place. And as you can see, this is how it's looking. This is how the shock absorber is looking on this car. And like I told you all, don't let the caliper hang on the brake lines. Okay everybody, so as you can see, I have right here the new pieces which I'm going to install on the car. Right here I have the flanges, the top flanges which are going over the shock absorber. I bought them from Saks. This is the manufacturer which I choose to go with. Also I have right here the protection from the piston of the shock absorber. I also choose to go with Moro. And right here I have the shock absorber itself. This is how it's looking. I'm not exactly sure which manufacturer this was. Don't really matter what the manufacturer you chose to go with, because if the piece is new, this is meaning that it will work properly. Okay everybody, so before installing the shock absorber, I recommend all to push the piston inside the shock absorber a few times until it will build up some pressure. And only after that you can go ahead and assemble all the pieces together and put it back on the car. I also bought for this car the two mounting supports made by rubber, which will go under the front springs, so you'll have to put one piece over the spring and you'll have to put the other piece over the shock absorber. Also, those pieces are made by Febi. This is the manufacturer which I chose to go with, and I also recommend all to buy those two pieces brand new, because they are not so expensive and they will make a huge difference in how the car is feeling and behaving on the road. Okay everybody, from here just follow what I'm doing, just do the exact same steps which I'm doing right here. And if you want to do this job at home and with normal tools, with your tools, I recommend all to buy this special press, which you can use on almost any car to compress the springs from the shock absorber, and this will be a huge improvement in your tools, and this will make your life a lot easier, because if you don't have a tool like this, you won't be able to compress the springs safely and you won't be able to replace all of these things at home and with normal tools. After you're done with assembling the parts all together, you'll have to put the shock absorber back on the car. You'll have to tighten first at the top. You'll have to put the three screws, but you don't want to tighten them completely. You will only want to tighten them just a little bit to make sure that the shock absorber will stay mounted to the top part of the car. Then you'll have to bend it just a little bit until it will go inside the hub, and from there you'll have to put all the pieces back together in the same way as you disassembled them, and from here it's very simple. Until now, I didn't tighten any bolt, I just mounted the parts all together, and from here I just want to show you all how everything is looking and how you will have to put everything back on the car. Make sure you install the flanges in the correct position at the top, and from here you'll have to put everything back together, you'll have to tighten everything to spec, and you'll be good to go. Okay everybody, now I'm done with replacing the shock absorber back on this car. This is how to replace your front shock absorber on any BMW 3 Series E46 from any year. So as you can see, I replaced the sway bar links and also the shock absorber and all the parts from the shock absorber. This is how everything is looking. Thank you all for watching. If you like this video and found it informative, please leave a like and a comment down below. See you next time.